अस्सलामुअलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाह। औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश्शैतानिर रजीम। बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। इन्नल हमदलिल्लाह नहमदुहु व नस्तईनुहु व नस्तगफिरुहु व नऊज़ु बिल्लाहि मिन शुरूरि अन्फुसिना व मिन सय्यिआति अमालिना। वी सीक प्रोटेक्शन विद अल्लाह सुभानहु व तआला from the evils that our own hearts and minds teach us, and when we have committed the disobedience and it has been written as a sayyiat, the evil deeds that we have done, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect from the punishment of those evil deeds. Allah's judgment is that may yahdillah, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided to guide. Fala mudilla lahu, there is no one who can mislead a person like him. On the other hand, because of the deeds of the people, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides to leave someone in the state of وَمَنْ يُدْلِلْ, Allah's judgment and decree is that fala hadiya lahu, there is no one who can guide a person like that. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, and I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worshipping illa, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger and prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes in the Quran in many places for the human being to live the life of consciousness, the life of taqwa, the life of fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every matter from morning till evening and the next day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very importantly addresses first the mankind, among the mankind those who have already submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by reminding ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah, for those of you who have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have fear, have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not just by saying with your tongue, but haqqa tuqatihi, as is the right to fear him, as is the right to have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us a very important thing in the continuation of the same ayat, that وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّا إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Make sure that you submit every minute of your time, every minute of your life, because you don't know when your last breath is going to come. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّا, make sure you do not die, the death does not reach upon you, but you are in the state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses all the mankind, that because they all are the creation that he created, by addressing them by ayyuhan nas, O all the mankind, O all the people, have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ittaqu, it's a command, it's a order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Collectively, have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you do not believe in him, but he is your creator. And Allah says, defining himself, Rabbakum, he is your Lord. Who is your Lord? Khalaqakum min nafsim wahida, he has created all of you, every one of you, starting with a single soul. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further explains that wa khalaqa minha zawjaha, and he has created its spouse at the same pattern. And then by the combination of the two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says wa bassa minhuma rijalan kathiran wa nisaa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spread on the face of this earth a great multitude of males and females. Wattaqullah, again Allah reminds you that have taqwa, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tasa'aluna bihi, because you ask each other through him. Walarham, and fear the relationship of the wombs, that when the children are born, they play together, and when they grow up, they go on their own life, they don't even see each other many, many years. Or even if they live next to each other, they don't talk to each other. It's a very common thing that happens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah kana alaykum raqeeba. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching every action that you are doing. Amma baal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, Fadhakkir bil Quran. Remind each other through the Quran. So inshallah, I will remind ourselves through some verses of the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has addressed in many, many ayats a very unique topic. A very unique statement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so the conversation and the ayats that I'm going to explain today are the etiquettes and manners that Quran is teaching us about talking, communication, speaking, how we talk to each other, how we say something, what we say. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not left us alone, but has guided us through the Quran many, many places that how should we be able to speak to each other and what should we say to each other. So it becomes a society where Allah's commandments are followed or there is no dispute. So first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ar-Rahman, in a very simple two words ayat, He says, وَعَلَّمَهُ الْبَيَانِ. He is the one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the mankind by saying that He is the one, Allah Himself is the one who has given the knowledge, the ilm, the allama is teaching, like a teacher is teaching you. Allah Himself is teaching the bayan. What is bayan? And how is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us? We are born by the best combination Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put together. Ahsan taqweem, best of the mixture of the all the things, best of the combination. We are born, we are given all kinds of abilities, but one thing that we are born with is that we don't know how to speak at that moment, at that time. But as we grow up very slowly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is teaching us how to speak. And that is the bayan. Allamahu, Allah is teaching. Imagine that a child of the age of 1 or 2 years, he cannot speak a word. But when you say something to that child, that information goes into his mind and it is converted in a certain way that he can repeat that word. He will repeat. If you say to the child, mom, he will repeat the word mom, even though he has never spoken that before. What is this? This is the teaching. This is the allama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the knowledge to the human being as he or she is growing up of the ability of bayan, ability of communication, ability of talking. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not left us alone without teaching further. As we grow up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in one of the ayats of the Quran that a father, a very devoted father, very humble father is teaching his very young child by saying, وَغْدُدْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ. Keep your voice lower. وَغْدُدْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ. Saut is the voice that we speak. He is teaching his son that when you talk to the people, make sure that you have a politeness in your speech, your conversation. Do not be arrogant in your statement. That's the very first lesson Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching to the progeny of the human being through the elder, the father. So in Surah Luqman, وَغْدُدْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ. Keep your voice polite. Humility should be there when you are talking to someone. And then he gives an example. He says that the words of the voices, إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. Words of the voices that you can hear is the voice of a donkey. So do not try to be acting that you have arrogance in your voice and it is not appreciated. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Ahzab again trains the mankind by saying, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah. O all of you who have believed in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have taqwa. But what has Allah added now? وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. Make sure when you speak, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching the mankind in all these verses the etiquettes, the manners of communication, the manners of talking to each other and others. So Allah says, وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. When you talk to each other, make sure that you speak upright. Make sure that you do not have any ambiguity in your conversation. Make sure you don't have any confusion when you say something. Make sure that you are not lying when you are saying something. That is the definition of qawlan sadida, very upright, straight. Because if you don't do that, it is going to be definitely creating the fitna and the problems in the society. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising a very detailed reward about just by that you are speaking. And remember that you are speaking to each other, you're not talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying qawlan sadida. When you are talking, when you are making a statement in the society, make sure that it is honest, it's a sincere statement, it's an upright statement. When you are doing that, and here, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not emphasizing that you must be the most righteous and devoted person and praying 24 hours a day. No. Living as a human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising in the same ayat, وَيُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. If you only speak upright, if you are only honest what you are saying, if you are sincere what you are saying, if you are not lying what you are saying, Allah says, يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. He will reform for you your deeds. He will correct for you your deeds. If you are doing something wrong, Allah's help will come in there and He will reform you. Not only that, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. He will forgive you all these dhunub, is the plural of sins. Zambun is one sin, dhunub is the sins. And when you have done, already committed the sins, Allah says, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. He will forgive you because you are speaking qawlan sadida. You are not asking forgiveness. You are doing the right statement and Allah will reward you for that right statement, that He will forgive your sins. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Whosoever is going to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger. Allah says, Allah's promise is that فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. He has actually achieved a great success in this worldly life and in the hereafter. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another place teaches us how to communicate, what to say, what not to say in Surah Al-Isra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He is commanding Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger, وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي. O Prophet, say, speak up to my servants, my slaves, يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحَسَّن. They should speak, they should say something which is أَحَسَّن. أَحَسَّن is a superlative degree of goodness. The best statement, whatever you say, make sure that before you speak in normal conversation, in talking to each other, that you, your tongue should bring out the best of the statement with all kind of good qualities and sincerity in them. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pointing in the same ayat, Inna shaitana yanzahu bainahum. Shaitan has a purpose. The purpose of the shaitan is to create a conflict between you. And Allah says, Inna shaitana kana lil insani aduwwan mubeena. Indeed, shaitan is an open enemy for the mankind, for the human being. And when you are talking, just even two friends are talking to each other, or two women are speaking to each other, shaitan is going to be present there, and his most effort will be that one person says something which is negative, which is against what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to say, and that will create a fitna, that will create an issue, a problem, because Allah is saying that his main purpose, the shaitan, is to create a conflict And the conflict is yaqulu allati. Make sure that whenever you are speaking, you are speaking the truth, you are speaking the honesty. Otherwise, think of that shaitan is sitting there and you don't want, because he has promised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will be an open enemy to the mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many, many places has reminded us that watch for shaitan's ability to create a dispute among you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Isra again reminds the mankind, along with certain things that a person should do, is that وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ, your Lord has decreed, he has judged, he has decided, Allah ta'budu illa iyyahu, that make sure you do not worship anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again is coming to the point of qawlan sadida, speaking the straight and truth. Allah first says that make sure that you are kind to your parents. Make sure when they are reaching the old age, you are humble, you are kind to your parents. Not only that, Allah further says, إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّا, if they reach to the age in the kalkibari, that when they are with you or you are around them, they have attained the older age. Ahaduhuma aw kilahuma. Here Allah says, either one of them, father or mother, or the both of them, the parents, if they attain the old age while you are there, Allah again is reminding about the ability of human being to speak with the kindness by saying فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ. Make sure you do not even say the smallest word of disrespect to them. Uff is used very commonly, very openly, but it's what is behind that word uff is that you are telling the person that I disagree with you, I don't care for you, you have done something wrong. Do not even say a single word of smallest disrespect to your fathers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in the Quran how to have the sense of responsibility of speaking the right way and the right word. Allah says, وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا, make sure do not insult them, do not humiliate your parents. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the word kareem for the word that you are speaking to your parents, to your fathers. So again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again is teaching us in the Quran how to be speaking with responsibility, how to say something which shows respect to others. What are the etiquettes of speaking to others? There are many, many ayahs, but I will try a few more. Allah says in Surah Al-Araf, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu la tarfa'u aswatakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that make sure you do not raise your voice. Tarfa'u is rafa, means to raise up. La tarfa'u is a command, it's a hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala collectively to the whole society. La tarfa'u aswatakum, do not raise your voice like you're screaming or shouting. فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ, upon the voice of the Prophet at that time. But then a scholar says that anytime you are communicating with your elders, make sure you do not raise your voice so they feel insulted and humiliated and disrespected. Allah says, what will happen if you do that? يَحْبِطُ عَمَالُ, Allah says, تَحْبَتَ عَمَالَكُمْ, your deeds will be wasted. Whatever good deeds you are doing, they will be wasted as a punishment because you have raised your voice to show your disapproval and insult to your elders. Allah further says, وَأَسِرُّ قَوْلَكُمْ أَوِجْهَرُوا بِهِ, and make sure that you either speak quietly or loudly. Make sure you speak the truth. Why? Because innahu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alimum bidhati sudur, he knows everything which is in your hearts. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further reminds in Surah Al-Hujurat. Here he is mentioning several things, but near the end of the ayat Allah says, wala yaghtab, بعضكم بعضا make sure you do not do the backbiting of each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forbidding to do that in the Quran. So next time when you are talking about third person, two of you are sitting together and you are talking about the third person, or you want to make a bad comment about that third person, make sure you remember this verse of the Quran in Surah Al-Hujurat. وَلَا يَغْتَبْ. يَغْتَبْ is from غِيبَتْ. Allah says, وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضَ each other. Do not talk the bad, do the bad biting of one another. So follow the instructions of the Quran and it will definitely, inshallah, change your life. Now, at the end, I just want to remind two more ayats of Surah Ibrahim. In one ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the example of a kalimatun tayyiba. A good word. Kalima is a statement, a word that you are talking and speaking to another person. Allah says, what is a tayyib, pure, good word? Allah says, the example of the kalimatun tayyiba is kashajaratin tayyiba. Is like a tree, which is pure and beautiful and tall tree. And how this tree is behaving? Allah says, asluha thabitun, its roots are firmly in the ground, so the wind or anything cannot shake it. And faruha fissama, its branches are reaching up in the sky, and it is standing there, it's bringing its fruits. That's the example of a good word that you say to another person, kalimatun tayyiba. On the other hand, in the next ayat, Allah is giving the example of a kalimatun khabisatun, a bad word, an evil word that you speak to another person. Allah says, what is the example of a kalimatun khabisatun? A bad word is a kashajaratin khabisatun, a tree which is an evil tree. And this evil tree is so unfirm that you just pull this off the ground, there is no stability in that tree. Which means bad word doesn't last very long, except it creates a fitna. But on the other hand, a good word is like a good tree that gives the fruit and benefit to the people all the time. So these are some of the examples, and there are many more examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given in the Quran that we should follow and obey the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the conversation that we have with other people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand the Quran and act upon. Sadaqallahu alayhi wa sallam. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم الله سبحانه وتعالى reminds us إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان الله commands you, الله instructs you to do the justice and do the ihsan, the kindness, wa ita'izil qurba, and be kind to your near relatives. Wa yanha anil fahsha, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids from indecent actions and indecencies. Wal munkar, and the wrong thing. Ya'izukum la'allakum tazakkarun, he advises you that you may be reminded. Allah says, Uzkurullah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Yawmul Jum'ah, the Salatul Jum'ah is a zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Uzkurullah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yazkurkum, he will remember you. Washkuruhu, and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yazidkum, he will increase his bounties upon you, just being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of whatever he has bestowed upon you today. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sins that we have committed all the time. Allah says, وَاتَّقُوهُ Have taqwa, have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مَخْرَجًا If you are in a difficult situation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you out of those وَاقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ and let's pray the salat.